the set of all triples of real numbers with the standard vector addition but with scalar multiplication defined by k times x, y, z is equal to k squared x, k squared y, k squared z. Is this set a vector space? So now, as you know, there should be 10 axioms that, when satisfied, will guarantee you that the given set is a vector space. However, I'm going to recommend you to check an axiom that you intuitively think might fail, right? So here, you're not given any definitions as to the precise definitions of the vector addition, because it says the set of all triples of real numbers with a standard vector addition, right? So there are no limitations there. So I'm not going to check any addition axioms, right? I'm just going to test the scalar multiplication axiom, one of them, because I know that there is a constraint here, right? There's a constraint. There's a definition of a certain way that the scalar multiplication is to be carried, right? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to test the axiom number 8. So the axiom number 8 is that k plus m multiplied by the object u should be equal to k times u, object u, plus m times u, right? And obviously k, m are scalars. Okay, so I'm gonna test this against the constraint that we're given here. If this axiom will fail, I'm gonna say this is axiom number 8. If this axiom fails, then obviously this set is not a vector space. Okay, the set described here in the question is not going to be a vector space, right? So k and m are scalars and u is an object. Okay, and we know that u is already given here. The u is going to be x, y, z, right? Because by nature we're given the scalar multiplication constraint that the scalar k multiplies this object x, y, z, right? So now let's test this. So k plus m multiplied by u, right? So k plus m u is going to be k plus m multiplied by x, y, z, right? X, y, z. And that gives you what? And remember, we have to make sure that we follow the constraint. So basically what you do here, you substitute k with k plus m here in the definition, in the defined scalar multiplication operation, right? So that's going to be squaring the k plus m, the sum, right? So that's going to be so I'm just going to distribute k squared the same way that it's distributed here, but this time we're going to square k plus m, right? So I'm going to do k plus m, which is squared, multiplied by x, k plus m, which is squared, multiplied by y, k plus m squared, multiplied by z. All right? So we already showed what this side is equal to, right? This is equal to that. Now let's test the right side. What is KU plus MU? And again, you have to follow the given constraint here. KU is going to be KXYZ plus M multiplied by XYZ. And now we can follow the constraint, right? K squared x, k squared y, k squared z, plus m squared x, m squared y, m squared z. And now you can add these guys, right? Because when you add components of vectors, you basically formulate a vector with the sum. So you will have k squared plus m squared times x, k squared plus m squared times y, k squared plus m squared times z. Okay, now notice this is not equal to this result. How do I know that? Because if you use the FOIL method, you will get one extra term. You will get 2km if you square this properly. And there's no 2km here. There's only the first term, k squared, and the last term, m squared, the third term. But the middle term, 2km, right? When you multiply the polynomial by itself here, is not going to give you this. It's going to give you one extra term, 2km. So this is not equal. So in this case, this is not satisfied. So I'm just going to say this part is this part right here. Right? So we just show that these two guys are not equal under the given constraints. So therefore, not a vector space axiom number 8 fails. Okay, so once the axiom fails, you don't have to check any other axiom, because you just showed that as long as one of the axiom fails, not a vector space. That's it. Thanks for watching. Hope this was helpful. See you in the next video.